There you go. So let's bring in here Sean Langcake, Head of Macroeconomic Forecasting at Oxford Economics, who's with me. Sean, more economists are now pushing their forecasts of when interest rates are going to be cut further out. What's your own sense of that, given what we've heard from the governor today?
Yeah, I think as she alluded to, they're going to need a great deal of confidence that inflation's on its way back to target. I don't think even two positive CPI reads are going to give that to them. And there's also plenty of scope still for a bit of an upside surprise on inflation on the way through. So we're not expecting a cut until November. But really, the chances are that, you know, it's even later than that, more so than being brought forward.
Yeah, so the change in language, and I mean, we can see where the cash rate's gone historically, and now it's become pretty flat. Here's some of the assumptions. Wages growth appears to have peaked with indications it will moderate in the year ahead. Real incomes have stabilised and are expected to grow from here. Expect to support growth in consumption later this year as well. Kind of, that's one interesting thing. That is kind of like the steady as she goes, if you like, forecast of the Reserve Bank, isn't it?
It is. Look, we've really only just got real incomes growing again, having gone backwards for the last couple of years with inflation running so hot and taking such a bite out of people's paychecks. So we are moving to a position where we're going to have a little bit more support for consumption, tax cuts from the second half of the year. That's going to help as well. That is all to the upside for inflation. It means they're going to take a very patient approach in easing policy.
So it's a very patient approach, but taking off that language which says we might even raise rates. And this is it. This has been deleted from the previous month's statement, and a further increase in interest rates cannot be ruled out. We can see also what they've replaced that with. The board is not ruling anything in or out. So the language has subtly but very clearly changed.
It has. I think it's worth bearing in mind that market expectations were pretty dovish around the time of that previous statement. So I think what the bank has seen is those expectations have lifted a little bit. They're more comfortable with where the market sees policy rates going, and they've kind of softened that language ever so slightly.
OK, but can I make an observation to you? People who go out in your hometown of Adelaide, which is the hottest property market in Australia right now, if they go out on Saturday and buy a house, they're buying in anticipation of the Reserve Bank cutting interest rates. A lot of people appear to have almost locked it in. The rates are going to be cut later this year. What the Reserve Bank is saying, kind of, is, well, don't necessarily make that assumption. It might take longer than that.
Yeah, I think they do well to remind people to pump the brakes on those kind of expectations. Now, 1 year is kind of short in the life of a mortgage, and hopefully people can kind of ride that out. But yeah, if for those that have had an expectation that rate cuts are coming halfway through the year, kind of August-ish, I think they're going to be a little bit disappointed and they're going to have to wait a little longer.
She was asked also quite a lot about wages growth, because wages growth could stimulate inflation. She was asked about healthcare workers getting wage rises, and her response to that was interesting there. Said, well, basically, I don't think healthcare workers who are very deserving of wage rises and have probably been underpaid for a long time, that's not really going to affect our assumptions whatsoever. So she's taking this pretty magnanimous view as to where the economy is going to.
Yeah, look, there's a ton of inertia baked into our wage setting system, and we are seeing a bit of a handover from those on individual agreements that could react really quickly when the unemployment rate was down at 3.5%. Bit of a handover now to kind of industries dominated by the public sector and EBAs that are resetting. Some of these wouldn't have reset at all over the last 3 years. So there's a bit of catch-up to be had there. And while they say wage growth has peaked, that's true in Q-on-Q terms, but it's still going to stay at a pretty brisk pace.
And just very quickly, the media conferences that are being had, this, you know, rhetoric, the more information we're getting, useful or not?
I think so. I do think it's come at the expense of a bit more information in the statement that comes out at 2:30, which, for those that can't necessarily tune into a press conference, it's a bit of a cost there.
I'll tell you what, Sean Langcake, good to have in the program. Normally in Adelaide, here today. Many thanks for your time.
Thanks, Ross.